Hey SD fans, welcome back. And for those here for the first time, my name's Mark. I'm the editor-in-chief of the Scuba Diver media brand, and welcome to the Scuba Diver YouTube channel. Now, there are a few countries globally that can compete with Grenada and Carriacou when it comes to shipwrecks. Never mind just in the Caribbean. And incredibly, many of the sunken vessels were genuine maritime accidents, not purpose-sunk artificial reefs. Even better, because the islands sit near a busy trade route, the number of wrecks is going up all the time. Me, I'm a certified wreck hound with a lust for rust, and I've dived the island several times in the past 20 odd years. So join me as I take you on a whistle-stop tour around some of Grenada and Carriacou's best shipwrecks. You can't talk about wreck diving in Grenada without first mentioning the mighty Bianca C, a gigantic 180 metre long, 18,000 tonne Italian liner which went down off the coast of Grenada in 1961. The Bianca C was built in 1939 on the south coast of France, and then after being launched as an incomplete ship, was sunk by German forces in August 1944. The hull was raised in 1946 and taken back to its original shipyard, where it was refitted and launched as a cruise ship in 1949. She then became known as the Arosa Sky in 1957 after being sold, before finally, in 1959, she was bought by the G. Costa de Genoa Company and was renamed Bianca C after a daughter in the family firm. She was tasked with a run from Italy to Venezuela, and Grenada was her last stop on the return leg. On the 22nd of October 1961, while anchored off St. George's, an explosion in the boiler room saw the vessel catch fire. Hordes of local boats, ranging from sailing boats, power boats, tiny dinghies, to ocean-going yachts and inter-island trading schooners, even rowing boats, responded to the crisis, rescuing all but one person who perished on board. Sadly, of 12 badly burned crew, two other men died later. Showing the friendliness and generosity the Grenadiers were renowned for, all of the rescued passengers were given food and shelter in hotels, guest houses, and even private homes. British frigate HMS Londonderry was in Puerto Rico and sailed down to Grenada to assist. When the naval vessel arrived on the 24th of October, the Bianca C was still ablaze. The frigate managed to take the huge liner in tow with an aim to move it away from the shipping lanes, but it proved problematic due to Bianca C's rudders being jammed, and eventually the towing line snapped and the ship sank, which is how it came to rest upright in 50 metres of water off Pink Gin Beach. I first dived this behemoth in 1999, and it was still very much shipshape at that point, but nearly 60 years on the seabed has taken its toll on the old girl, and she is deteriorating year on year. But there's no taking away from the epic scale of this enormous vessel, and she still makes a fine flagship for the rest of Grenada and Carriacou's sunken fleet. It's still possible to make out key aspects of the ship, including the swimming pool, bollards, winches, parts of the superstructure, and the bow chain and rope locker. In terms of marine life, you often get large shoals of Atlantic spadefish cruising above the wreck, along with large barracuda, eagle rays, and even the odd reef shark. As I said before, due to its location on various shipping routes, Grenada is also blessed with a plethora of shipwrecks that were the result of maritime accidents, and now provide underwater playgrounds for divers and protective habitats for marine life. The 50 metre freighter Shakem was carrying much needed bags of cement for the building industry on Grenada when she was caught in a storm in May 2001. The heavy cargo shifted and she went down, settling upright in 30 metres. The remnants of the bags of cement can clearly be seen in the hulls. The cement has set and the bags have long since fallen apart, leaving giant pillows stacked neatly in piles. But her rail draw is the rich smothering of coral and sponge growth that seems to cover every square inch of her hull, superstructure, and especially the large crane lying amidships. But perhaps the highlight is the rear of the ship that almost looks like a fluffy white wall dive due to the thick coating of coral. Smaller than the Shakem, at a length of 40 metres, the Veronica L is a freighter which sank after springing a leak, but was then raised and moved to a location near Grand Anse after work began on the cruise ship dock. Now lying in 15 metres, she's a perfect wreck dive for all levels, and is adorned in marine growth and fish life. The Atlantic side of Grenada, which is often rougher with large swells, but also benefits from having tremendous visibility, is home to several world-class shipwrecks. The King Mitch makes for an unusual wreck dive, given that she resembles a box with a pointed front. Originally a US Navy minesweeper from World War II, she was retrofitted into a freighter by having two cargo holds inserted in her middle, with a crane attached to the deck between them. She lies several miles offshore on her side in just over 30 metres, and sank in 1981 when her bilge pump failed. There is some coral growth on her, but as the wrecks on this side of the island are often swept by sometimes fierce currents, it's nowhere near as prolific and dense as on the Caribbean side. What it does have is nurse sharks, lots of them, and southern stingrays, not to mention patrolling barracuda and amberjack. A little closer to land is the cargo vessel Hema 1, which had delivered a consignment of cement to the island and was en route back to Trinidad on the 1st of March 2005, when she was also the victim of a failed bilge pump and ended up in 30 metres of water. Shortly after being sunk, she was broken apart by hurricane surge, and now the hull and bow lie on their port side with the midship's well flattened. This wreck is another haunt for nurse sharks, which swarm in large numbers under the hull plates and near the bow, and reef sharks sometimes pay a fleeting visit from out of the blue. The latest vessel to join Grenada's underwater fleet on the Atlantic side was the Persia II, which went down in 35 metres in March 2017. Coral growth on this cargo ship is fairly sparse at the moment, but marine life has already started to move in with various reef fish and the invasive lionfish in residence. I dived this when it had literally been down a few weeks, and it was very weird to dive a wreck that was so clean and fresh. But even then, there were already a few inquisitive reef fish staking a claim in the superstructure. Not that I necessarily need it with such a selection of genuine shipwrecks, but Grenada and Carriacou also boast several artificial reefs, and more are in the pipeline. Grenada has the Buccaneer, a sloop sunk way back in 1978 that lies on its starboard side in just 23 metres and is well festooned with marine growth, as is the cargo ship Hilda, which has been down since 2007 and lies in Grand Mal Bay in 35 metres. The 60-metre container ship Anina languished in Grand Anse Bay for several years before finally being green-lighted as an artificial reef, but she ended up going down slightly earlier than planned at the end of March 2018 after starting to take on water, and she can be found lying on her side in some 30 metres of water. It's a stunning dive with the flat bottom of the vessel liberally coated in orange cup corals. So much so, it resembles a wall dive, and the cavernous holes are also open for exploration. The latest wreck was the Tyrrell Bay, a former US Coast Guard patrol boat which went down at the end of September 2018 close to Boss Reef off Grand Anse Beach. The result of a two-year public and private sector project, the wreck still has many interesting features, including a safe, telephone, compasses, control panels and levers, and even a few toilets, and its shallow depth means it can be enjoyed by all levels of diver, even free divers. On Carriacou, you have the twin tugs, two vessels sitting within a short distance of one another in 27 to 30 metres, though for a thorough exploration of both, the best visited individually due to the depth. Both are around 30 metres in length. The West Sider was sent to the bottom on the 4th of September 2004, and the Boris followed on the 10th of September 2007. The two wrecks are covered in vibrant red and orange encrusting corals and algae, and penetration into the interior is possible on both. Currents can sometimes sweep across them, and they're home to angelfish, wrasse, soldierfish, lobster and moray eels. This duo were joined in January 2018 by the 38-metre tugboat Mammoth Troll. The Troll, as it is known, is now on the bottom in 35 metres in an upright position. Penetration is possible into various sections of the vessel, and there's a great swim through running the length of the superstructure on the starboard side. So, as you can see, Grenada and Carriacou boast a plethora of shipwrecks. This is fantastic news for divers, whether you are a newly qualified open water diver or a hardcore diving veteran or tech diver. And if you are into your sunken metal, never fear. The sheer amount of marine growth and fish life that lives on and around the wrecks means every dive is a swirling riot of vibrant colour. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and ring that bell so you get notification for all our new videos. As always, if you're going diving in the coming days, enjoy yourself. Stay safe.